You know that I'ma get it, nigga, get it. I gotta hustle to my death for sure. I'ma get it, nigga, get it. If I don't do nothing else, you know that I'ma get it, nigga, get it. I gotta hustle to my death for sure. I woke up this morning and we rolling. Two Fly Keith Logan. I got Jay Howe with me this time. I got Jay Howe with me this time.
We already know.
Right, he got his threes up, as usual.
All day.
So, bro, you been rapping for the 330, you know what I'm saying? You been going hard since about 08. I ain't gonna say going hard since 08, because you know what I'm saying? When was the first time that you really, you know what I'm saying, that you got into music, bro? What inspired you to start getting into music?
Well, you know, be for real, what a lot of people don't know is, you know, I had, always had love for music, for real. I love listening to music, you feel me? So, it was like, I listened to a lot of different music, man. I listened to all kinds of music. I listened to the regular music people listen to. I listened to a lot of R&B music. I listened to, it's a few, you know what I'm saying?
Different genres.
Yeah, a lot of genres, you feel me? So, all that built in, you know what I'm saying, keep my mind at a wide, you know what I'm saying? I gotta hustle to my death for sure. I'ma get this motherfucking guap though. I live a thug life, bet you even Pac know. I'm gracing every damn beat with this hot flow. And that's the reason why I'm on the fucking top, ho. I've been getting it
Okay. Right back at y'all, you know what I'm saying?
They love.
Jay Howe, you know what I'm saying? Got you here, and you know, some one thing that you was talking about that I wanted to talk to you about, and you wanted me to ask you about, you know what I'm saying, was, you know what I'm saying, basically down that lane of like public perception and image, you know what I'm saying? And I mean, you take it from there, how it crashes people's career, how people try to put on such a facade to where it ruined their career, or to where, is it a point where you can be too real? Can that ruin your career? Like, what?
Right.
Talk about this public perception, this image, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, not just about you, but however you want to put it out there. Like.
Well, you know, you got a lot of artists, man. You got a lot of rappers, man. This city right here, Youngstown, it's grimy, man. It's real, it's trill, it's poverty, you feel me? It's the struggle, it's all of that, you feel me? So I feel like, you know, it's good parts to it too, don't get me wrong, it's good parts to the city. And you know, everybody ain't experienced some of the same things. And we kinda have experienced some of the same things. But, you know, you got differences out here, you know, it's people who really tied in and in tune with the streets. And it's people who really just always been distant from the streets, but kind of know somebody who was tied to the streets, you know what I'm saying?
Right,
and always
right.
Wanted to feel like they was tied to the streets or whatever. And when I say that, it's no specific person I'm speaking on. It's really just, you know, how this life is, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm big on that. I really view and look at and observe a lot of people, demeanors, their characteristics, everything. I'm big on that. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm really in tune with a lot, man. You know, I done been through a lot that a lot of people haven't. A lot of people have. People been through things I haven't been through, you feel me? But, you know, I only speak about my life, man. And that's pretty much how easy it is to understand everything I feel like. Because you're going to get all of that through my music. Just
well, I guess, you know what I'm saying? You're going to be speaking your life. What is Jay Howe's life like at this very moment in life? Like, what is your life like right now?
Like, well, you know, at this moment, you feel me? I had a birthday last week.
Okay, happy
just
belated.
Turned.
Happy
yeah,
belated birthday anniversary, Jay Howe.
Appreciate that. You know what I'm saying? I turned 24. You know what I'm saying? Rest in peace to my brother Reese. You feel me? Just, you know, he was killed. You feel me? Lost him at the beginning of this same month. You know what I'm saying? My birthday month, April. Mm-hmm. And went to jail, you know what I'm saying, about 2-3 days after he was killed, you feel me, you know, got locked up, you know what I'm saying, and they didn't took $2,000 off me, I bonded out $2,000 more. You know, just dealing with, you know what I'm saying, some of the things I deal with, but that's what this music about, you know what I'm saying? I'm really chasing this dream, but I gotta, you know what I'm saying, really stay dedicated to it, man. And I do that, you know, I try my hardest to do that. Chapter in my life, every CD, man, it's just too real, man. But you know, pretty soon, man, I know it's coming, man. It's getting closer. I'm chasing it down, and I ain't gonna stop. You feel me? So, threes up all day.
Threes up. Hey, threes up. Rapping at 3:30. I see you rapping at 3:30. Threes up. What's up, huh? So that's what's up, bro. Hey. Thanks for coming.
No doubt, no doubt, man. It's a pleasure doing it, man. You know,
I'm repping for us.
I love it, man. I see you got everything going on, man. I support it, man. Anything going good, and that's one thing I want to say, man. It's a lot of rappers in the city that I do support, man. I don't want nobody getting confused, think I don't support, man, because I don't deal with a lot. I be doing a lot, man. I be moving, you know what I'm saying? That's just the way I am, but... It's a lot of niggas out that I really fuck with, man. Niggas I be listening, so I be checking them out. You know, I couldn't even shout out everybody that I fuck with, but you know, shout out to CP, you feel me? We got trash together. Shout out to, you know what I'm saying, Perry Boy, shout out to Two Fly, Keith Logan, Rondo Cut, Should Be, Him, you feel me? Shout out to my squad, the Hustle, Brent Boys All Day. Shout out to Tranny Go, ENT, my Cuddy B Bud, Cheese, you feel me? It's so much going on, man. I ain't gonna do it to y'all. I be here all day trying to shout out everybody that I fuck with, but it's a lot of niggas, man, and y'all know it, you feel me? And, you know, go hard, man. We gonna get it, man. It's 3-3-0, man. Threes up. Everybody screaming. Everybody repping, man. It don't matter. Let's get it.
I am gonna sneak one more question in, bro. You know what I'm saying? Because you say this often. You know what I'm saying? What does it take to be the king? You know what I'm saying? To be a king or be the king? Which one am I asking? What question am I asking you?
Okay, you know, and I'm glad you asked me that because, you know, it's like, you know, it's, you know, any last time I checked, ever know anything about a king and a queen? In every different place, you know, country, state, city, or whatever, you know what I'm saying, real Roman time, every country, mm-hmm. It was a king, it was a queen. It's only one, though. You feel me? Anything other than that, it's a prince, anything, it's lower levels, but, you know, it's only one, you feel me? And like you said, man, my work ethic, my struggle, my story, my whole everything, man, I got 15 mixtapes, I got 15 released to the streets, you feel me? Nobody else in the city, and not just saying in this city, but I don't even think nobody in the state of Ohio, I don't think it's a lot of cats own millionaires in the game who ain't even put out this much music. You know what I'm saying? But ain't nobody did some of the things that I did. And I'm continuing to go hard and continue doing it and setting my history, man, my greatness. But that's why I scream I'm the king, man, because I know I'm the one who did a lot of things that a lot of people haven't done, you feel me? And I'm just, you know, the music, man, speak for itself. It ain't about just having all of the music. It's about how great the music is, you feel me? A lot of great music it is, you feel me? So that's the biggest part to me, man. And to be real and be honest, nobody has done that like me. Nobody, you feel me? Nobody has done that like me. So that's just why it's the difference between the king and a king, and you feel me, everybody got, you know, you can have king on your name, that's cool, that's You know what I'm saying? Everybody got down, you know what I'm saying? However you want it. It's, and there's no disrespect. It's like, that's what's up. You know what I'm saying? I don't ever feel no type of way when I hear nobody else say nothing about being king. I swear, when I hear anybody say anything about saying about king, I don't ever feel no type of way because I know that I'm the king. My son, you know what I'm saying? You know, it's a life I got. I got a real life, you know what I'm saying? I got my girl, you go. I got my mama, I got my sister. I take care of the whole family, you know. Jay is the provider for the family, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That's been my image. That's been my role for, you know, a while, you feel me, since a youngin. And, you know, it's like that, man. You get it all through the music, you know what I'm saying? My brother, he hold me down. They always see him with me, you feel me? You already know what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. Look, bro, that's you feel
already,
me?
You already know, bro.
Three's up all day, he tell you that. You feel me? It's just, you know, I'm stuck in between two, you know, the streets, the music, you feel me? And it's like whatever come first for real for me at this point, you know what I'm saying? It's like, I know what I gotta really stay on and stay dedicated to, and then I know that I can't starve and let the family starve either, you feel me? So it's like, I do good with doing them both, you feel me? And I just, you know, this music need to take off, man. That's why I need the city behind me, recognize the gift that I got, man. It ain't like just putting nobody else off and don't deal with nobody else, but really get behind what we know we need, because I can do a lot for the city, man. I plan to do big things. Like, I want to pay the whole city. I want to pave the streets.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We got these potholes, they crazy. It's everywhere. It ain't even just certain parts now, up the hill, down the hill. It's like everywhere you go, the streets is, it's done for. They fucked up. You feel me? So,
yeah, a lot of people like, had a few car casualties.
Yeah, you feel me? And that's something we really don't want to deal with. I want to really, when I see my first million off this, and not even maybe, I know it's going to take more than a million. So, just, you know, as far as music go, like you said, I got so much music, and it ain't just I got so much music, but the music is all dope. When I get there and I'm getting paid for it, them albums gonna be nothing. It's gonna be triple platinum. I'm gonna be bringing in a lot of money. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna kill the game. I'm gonna be there to stay when I get there. No one ain't wonder, you feel me? I got those all day. And I'm gonna pay these streets. I'm gonna pay them for real, and that's something I always say I'm gonna do. And you watch, I'm going to do that, man, and that's going to be something big, you know what I'm saying? They're going to always remember me for that, because that's something everybody know we need. And even the old, the senior citizens would know me for something. They'd be like, the rapper who paved the streets. You feel me?
I dig that, bro.
It'll be a lot going on.
And that's, even that in itself goes to show, you know what I'm saying? It's a big difference of being a dreamer and being a visionary. You know what I'm saying? You got the goals, and I know I can ask you what you got going for this year, because you already see it. I know I can ask you what you see down the line, because you already see it. You already got the plan mapped out. It's just calculating these steps to execute it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, obviously, you don't got a problem putting the music out together. You know what I'm saying? Putting out, you got a lot of real life issues going on, and you putting that out through your music. You don't got a problem with that. You know what I'm saying? Your public perception, you feel like that's polished, or you polishing that. That's good to go. What when you say you want the city behind you, what do you want? You know what I'm saying?
I really, you know what I'm saying? You know we do, man, we got shows all the time, man.
Feel
local
you.
Shows, and it ain't feel too many places to really do them. And when we got them, it's like, you could be on Instagram, you could be on Facebook all week promoting, going hard.
Right.
And you know you can get 1,000 likes, but you know what I'm saying? It's really about they coming out and being there and just really being there to listen to the music and enjoy the music and really support somebody, you feel me? Even right. If you're there for somebody else. Don't nobody really come out, man, period, point blank. And I've been going hard for too long. My stage presence dope. Everybody who can see me know I kill the stage. It ain't just no performance, no open mic, you know what I'm saying? That's right. Why I really had to step back on a lot of the open mic things, because you know what I'm saying? I'm way beyond that, but it's too real to me. It's dear to me, so I've been in a lot of open mics weekend after weekend. Every, you know what I'm saying? Right. The lower level, they know about that, you feel me? It's right. Gone now, but they know I was in there every weekend. It could be two people in the crowd. I'm going hard, like it's 1,000. You know what I'm saying? I done performed at the Covelli, where it was thousands, you feel me? Mm-hmm. And you know what I'm saying? I did a little bit of it all, you feel me? And I just, you know, I know we need to get behind a real nigga and support, man, because I'm going to go hard. Just imagine what it's like. Y'all listen to this music and know that I go hard. It's easy for them to get attached to somebody from anywhere else that's just, you know what I'm saying, with some bullshit-ass music. And it ain't got to be bullshit because it's niggas that I fuck with. It's a lot of niggas. I've been off Rich Homie hard lately, you feel me, because he a real nigga and that's the type of shit that I can get attached to. But, you know what I'm saying, people around here get attached to that because they can see you at the corner store and they're like, he ain't nobody, he just from around here. But listen to this shit, for real, it's dope.
Right.
And you know what I'm saying, this city need a lot, and you support this, and you get behind it like you do anything else, and just let every nigga know this is what you've been off lately, this is what I've been off, and it's, right, it's going to be
word
a demand.
Right.
Yeah, it started demand.
So
you know,
so
I'm going to go hard.
So since like 08 to now, you know what I'm saying, it's 14, did you ever see a time when the city was supporting?
Yeah, man, I've seen support a lot of times, man. I feel a lot of support right now, to be honest, you feel me?
Where the whole city, it was a wave, like you felt they was behind the music, the whole, like you said, it could be anybody, they was behind the whole music scene, they was out, or do you feel like it's yet to come? Like,
it's yet to come.
Yet to come?
It's yet to come, but you know what I'm saying, it's getting close, man, I can feel it, like. You can catch me on the woods, sun up to sundown. No matter where I'm at, you know I'm repping Youngstown. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? My first track. That's my first track, and that was the intro to my first CD Rookie of the Year, because the feedback was aight for that. It gave me the inspiration to really try to record more songs, and as I did that, people was liking them. I'm letting them hear them as I make them. Niggas coming through the hood all day. You know what I'm saying? And from one CD to the next, man.
Right, and you said like it's nothing when you say from one CD to the next. But I'm going to go ahead and put the ESPN stat out there. You know what I'm saying? Jay Howell got 15 albums.
15.
You know what I'm saying? To date.
And
full. I'm not talking about no EPs, no demos, no singles. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Front to back, I say on average, you averaging probably like 16, 17 songs. You know what I'm saying? A CD.
I ain't never put nothing less than 18 on that.
Nothing less than 18. I'm corrected.
Yeah.
So that's an achievement right there.
Appreciate
for
that.
For artists to say you got 15 full albums, and you know,
I'm gonna let you in on the secret too.
Okay, let me know the secret. I've been trying to get the secret since like album number
it's
3.
It's a secret that nobody know. I'm sharing it with you right here, right now. You feel me? Too fly. So bam, 2011.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying. I don't know if you remember, of course you remember, but you know what I'm saying? Y'all don't know. You know, Fly, my designer on my CDs, you know what I'm saying? Do my cover art, you know what I'm saying? So, this is 2011 when I had did, I came with the J Howe self-titled, volume 2.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? On the cover with the 3s, the purple, green, black.
Right.
Yeah, did that, and that was all off the dome. So, 2011, what happened was on New Year's Eve, I was in the at the crib, chilling with my cutty, Will Chat. I'm like, man, I ain't going out. I ain't going to the club. I ain't doing nothing. I'm chilling. I'm going to work.
Okay.
So I'm like, what I'm going to try to do is, I ain't going to write nothing. And for the first time, I'm going to freestyle. You feel me? So I did it, you know, overnight. On December 31st, going into the 1st, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Like, from probably 10 o'clock to ending up at like 2 o'clock in the morning. So it was literally going in 2011. And I said, you know what? It came out to be dope. I'm like, I ain't gonna never, you know what I'm saying, write for the rest of the year. I ain't writing at all. Not one thing.
Not one thing.
So
and this was at album number?
This would be probably, the self-titled came after, I think self-titled was like 10.
So?
It'd have been 11. Somewhere around there.
So for the last 5 albums, you ain't wrote no rhyme since everything been off the dome.
Nah, listen, it's the secret.
Okay, I'm telling you.
So bam, I came with that CD, right?
Mm-hmm.
But see, that's not the first CD I had freestyle on and did. I had this little crib, I had the room, it had an echo in it, so I ain't really like it, but I recorded a whole mixtape. It's called Allergic to the Pen.
Mm-hmm.
Some people heard that before. Cause it was times when I was doing shows and I would do songs off that.
Okay.
As I was recording, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Bitches J Howe, I be going in 11 times on them, call me Mr. Flow of 10. All off the dome, you feel me? And that would have been my 11th mixtape, you feel me? But the quality wasn't all the way what I liked it, but that was the CD with 18 songs on it off the dome. and I had no features on it. Mm-hmm. Not one. It was all me. It was something I did in like 3 weeks, just sitting there recording, going. Because I'm geek with the freestyling thing now. So bam, I didn't never put that out. You feel me? But I put out the self-titled J Howard, then I dropped Again Volume 3.
Okay.
And then I did those two. Mm-hmm. Freestyle, that was 2011. That's the year 2011 I put out them two CDs. But it was really a third one that never got released. So in all reality, I got 16 mixtapes.